Morning. I don't know why I'm whispering, because there's no one else about. Well, it's because it's early. It's 4:45 kind of early. I'm feeling chirpy because I had about 5 hours sleep. Someone that's feeling less chirpy is Dave.
Morning.
How much sleep did you get?
Maybe an hour, maybe 20 minutes.
Well, this is going to be fun. This is going to be a whole video where Dave's had almost no sleep. We're here in Basingstoke to catch a very particular train. Yay!
Yes.
Let's do it. So we're heading for platform 4. We're getting the 4:54 from 4 at Basingstoke. I like the fact that sunrise this morning is also at 4:54, so the train departs at exactly the same time that the sun rises. Is this us? So this is 2 Lima 10, did I get that right?
Yeah.
It's the 4:54 Basingstoke to Waterloo, but via the district line.
The Southwestern Main Line to Woking comes up through Wimbledon. Eventually gets to Clapham Junction and into London Waterloo. At Clapham Junction, it meets another line that comes in from Reading and from Windsor, but connecting the two, London Southwestern Railway built a bit of track via East Putney and Southfield and Wimbledon Park down to Wimbledon. And if those names sound familiar, that's because that's now the district line.
I like Dave's map, but I thought I'd draw my own one here, which shows you that once a day, a train travels up and goes through the district line, passing through but not stopping at Wimbledon Park, Southfields and East Putney stations. And then there's a curve of track where it goes off and joins the main line again through Wandsworth Town and back up to Clapham Junction. And there's also one late night return service in the evening.
So there's all these strange bits of track and curves of track which get sort of one a day, maybe two a day, in some cases like one a week, or just odd services. On screen now is a website, PSUL, Passenger Services Over Unusual Lines. It used to be a standalone website, it's now part of the Branch Line Society website, is that right, Dave? So it's an amazing website and it lists all these weird and wonderful services. So Dave, is there a name for this hobby?
Rare track bashing, perhaps.
How long have you been doing this?
That's a good question. Probably 10 or 12 years now. It's been a long time of just gradually ticking off. Not just every rare bit, but every track in the country gradually.
So that you can say that you've ridden over every bit of rail.
Almost every line, certainly.
In the land.
There's a few bits and pieces I'm still missing.
Okay, so what we're going to do now, Dave, is that we're going to drop some graphics and we're going to do Dave's top 5 obscure pieces of track to bash.
Yeah, so here's 5 obscure pieces of track which get a very rare service and are hard to tick off. First is the Edinburgh Suburban Line, which avoids Haymarket and goes to Waverley the long way round, served by just one cross-country train a day. Second is one of my favourites. That's the lesser-used curve just to the north of Manningtree, where Greater Anglia trains from Harwich International curve around towards Ipswich instead of going down towards Manningtree. Third is one of Dave's favourites, that's the Swansea District Line, which avoids Swansea altogether and is usually done by trains meeting the boats at Fishguard Harbour. In South East London, there's the curve at New Beckenham, which is very rarely used, but sometimes engineering works at a weekend will divert all the services this way. Engineering side effects is often a good way to tick off obscure pieces of line. And then there's the line between Wolverhampton and Walsall, where one early morning train on a Saturday only, that's right, a once a week service, goes to Rugeley Trent Valley, using this curve for which the rest of the week sees no passenger services at all.
Where are we now? Farnborough.
I think so.
The sun has come up. So off camera, Dave's been telling me about a time you went to Swansea once, and what happened?
The train didn't use the diversion, it used the main line.
Which diversion was this?
This was the Ogmore Vale extension, which is sort of basically a route through Margam Yard near Portalbot. And the driver either didn't need to or couldn't drive that way, and we just used the normal route, sadly.
YouTube, something very unexpected.
This train is for London Waterloo. The next station is Woking.
Which isn't that funny. And that is, in the previous shot, you saw our friendly guard in the background come down. Hey Drew, our friendly guard, who came and chatted to us, and we literally said, oh, we're here to get the train that goes around the curve. And Dave was explaining how, via once, he went to Swansea and the train didn't then run. And the guard then went,
Sorry, the driver doesn't sign via East Putney.
So due to the pandemic, what's happened is that a lot of drivers have lost their route knowledge over the last, 18 months?
Yeah.
And today there's a driver change at Woking, and the driver that's getting on at Woking, he hasn't ridden the route for 6 months, and therefore isn't...
His confidence has lapsed.
So he hasn't got permission to ride the route. So we've honestly come all the way to Basingstoke to do this, and the train is
not
going to
do it.
And under my face mask, I'm trying to hide my disappointment. Is it working?
Right, Jeff.
Southwest, if you're watching, Dave and I spent money to stay in a hotel in Basingstoke, tickets and everything. In fact, we've been planning this all winter, because we almost did the new Beckenham curve. Dave went, no, this one's sort of easier to do, because you only have to go down to Basingstoke to do it in its entirety. And we've been scuppered.
What's that one doing? It's doing the connection between Byfleet and Newhall.
That's a rare curve as well, isn't it?
Yeah.
How often did that happen?
I think that's the only one on a Saturday, but they happen all day on Sundays, so that one's quite easy to do.
We should have got that. We've hit that moment of we've both been up early and without having breakfast. We've got to Clapham early because we weren't due to be here until 6:01 and it's 5:56. We've now got to sit at Clapham for 5 minutes. Can we get some breakfast at Waterloo? Dave looks so asleep.
Ladies and gentlemen, cigar speaking, shortly be arriving into London Waterloo.
I can't remember last time I was at Waterloo this early when it's so empty. Dave, we're doing the summing up shot. Let's go and do it outside. Such are the perils of weird, unique track bashing. Yep. Sometimes it just doesn't work.
Yep. Not the first time, won't be the last time. And you just got to take it as it comes.
Dave, I think it's your call. I think you get to tell me what we all know, what YouTube are all screaming for me to do, because you've ridden the track before, but I haven't, so...
You've got to come back someday next week and just go to Wimbledon one morning.
I have, haven't I? That's what I've got to do. Dave, thank you for coming to Basingstoke with me last night and this morning for an ultimately pointless journey. I think the video should now dramatically fade to black, and when it fades up, it'll be a whole new day. Fade up from black. Good morning. It's 5:30, 4 days later, I'm at Wimbledon. Surely today it'll run where it's meant to. I'm just going for this dramatic effect with the rising sun. Look at that. It says it's on time in 7 minutes' time. It's going to pull in on platform 5 and we'll go up the district line. I hope.
Ladies and gents, this is the South Western Railway service to London Waterloo, and we'll call at Clapham Junction, Vauxhall and London Waterloo.
And this time, everything went to plan. The train goes over the crossover and onto the District Line tracks and passes through Wimbledon Park, and then through Southfields without stopping, and then East Putney, where the double track passes alongside a platform here that's never used by an underground train. That double track becomes a single track though, as the line that arched over the main line has been removed, but wonderfully the abutments are still in place. The best way to see those though are to drop to Google Satellite View and check them out that way. The train then crosses over down onto the main line, stops at Clapham, then Vauxhall, and finally Waterloo.
6:15. 6:15. Train's at Waterloo, and this time there's no Dave to do the summing up. I've come back to the same point where we were on Saturday, but Dave, where are you? You're not here today. Links in the description to PSUL, Passenger Services Over Unusual Lines, and to the train we caught on Saturday and today, the one northbound in the morning, and there's one in the evening that comes back down as well. That's the Southwest train that runs over through the District Line and through those District Line stations. I'm thrilled to have done this twice. Thanks for watching. Please press subscribe. More videos to come. Thanks.